In the last lecture, we have seen the type first example of SFG. Today, we will discuss the type second. It is a construction of SFG, that is signal flow graph, from the given block diagram. And hence, determination of transfer function. In earlier example, that is type first example, we have seen that if we have the algebraic equations, how we are going to convert these algebraic equations into the signal flow graph, and then accordingly we can apply the Meissen's gate formula for obtaining the transfer function. In the second type, we are going to have the block diagram. We will have to convert this block diagram into the signal flow graph so that we can apply the Meissen's one formula. So we will take one example. Let us take the question. Determine the final transfer function, that is C of S over R of S and C of S over V of S. That means we have two inputs in the system by signal flow graph or the system show. And this is the system. We are taking these examples so that we can learn each and every steps that we can follow for conversion of this block diagram into the signal flow graph. So this is the block diagram that we are going to use for our example, and we will see how we are going to convert this block diagram into the signal flow graph. Now, if we go through this block diagram, it's very complex. It will take lots of time for solving the block diagram by using the block diagram reduction technique method and to have the final transfer function. That is why we will first try to convert this block diagram into the signal flow graph, and then we know that applying the Meissen's gate formula to the SFG is very easy as compared to the process that we follow for the block diagram reduction technique. So in this case, first of all, we'll have to take a node, that is, for to construct this SFG from the block diagram, we'll have to select the nodes on this block diagram. Now, the question is, where to point the node on this block diagram? So here, on this block diagram, the nodes are to be marked on these points. Number one, on all the inputs. Number two, all the outputs. Number three, output of summing point. And number four, takeoff points. So these are the four places where we can mark the nodes on this block diagram. So for conversion into the SFG, we will have to take care of all these things. First is to all the inputs, means wherever we have the inputs, we have to mark the node. Now we'll start marking the node. First we'll take care of the inputs. All the inputs. Here in this block diagram, we have two inputs. One is R of S, so let us mark this as one of the node. Second is V of S, so let us mark this as another node. So we are done with the first part. Since in this block diagram there are only two inputs, so we have marked this as two nodes, that is R of S and V of S. Now number two, all the outputs. Now just see here, in this case we have input as RS and VS. Rest of the blocks are the gains of the system, and C of S, this is the only output that we have over here. So we'll mark this as one of the node. Let us say this node is C of S. So that is the output node. So in this system we have two input nodes and one output node. Then number three, output of summing points. Just see, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. We have total 5 summing points. So we'll have to mark the output of summing point as one of the node. So this is the output of summing point. So let us say this is node. Here the name of this node is already there, that is R of S. Here the name of node is V of S. Here the name of the node is C of S. Now let us say that this is node A. So this is A. Then another summing point is there. We'll have to mark this as B. Of course I wish to mark this symbol. This is plus minus, this is plus minus. This is positive, this is negative, this is positive, this is negative. Here we have both the signals as positive. Now this second one is B. Now this is summing point that we have. Then output of this summing point, we cannot say this as C because we already used C for the output. So let us say this is D. Then here we have another summing point. Then output of the summing point is another node. So this is, let us say this is node E. Here there is no need to mark because we have already considered as C of S. So we have taken care of all the output of summing points. Now the last one is the takeoff points. Now we have to find how many takeoff points do we have. This is number one. This takeoff point is there. So let us mark this as one of the node. So this is node number F. Here also we have a takeoff point. So we call this as one node. Let us say this is node G. Now here there is a node, but we cannot mark this as a node because these two terminals are same. Basically, this particular node is representing the output of summing point as well as takeoff point. So this represents the same thing as this represents not only the output of summing point but also the takeoff point. So this will take care of all these connections. So this is all about the marking of nodes on this block diagram. Now we will see how to construct the SFG by using all these nodes. I'll remove all this. Now first of all, we'll have to mark all these nodes on the paper. So let us say this is the first node, that is R of S. We'll follow the same sequence. Second one is A. Then third one B. Then fourth D. The next one is E. Then we have here C of S. We have here B of S. Then F and G. Here we have F. Here we have G. So we have marked all the nodes. R of S, A, B, D, E, C of S, V of S, F and G. Now move from left side to right hand side. At node A, this is the output of this summing point. It has two incoming signals. One is through R of S and second one is coming to C of S via H4. So first of all, we'll follow the forward paths. We will not take care of the takeoff points that we are getting at the summing point. So here, it is moving R of S to A with a symbol, with a sign positive, and the gain is 1. So we will connect this R and A with a directed line which has a gain of 1. So R of S to A, this is 1. Then A to B, again it is moving without any
block, that means its gain is unity and the sign is positive. So here from A to B, again it has the gain of unity. Now B to T. Now B to T, from B, whatever we have at the B, that is multiplied by the gain G1 with the sign positive and that is reaching to the T. So B to T, we have the gain plus G1. So that this has G1. Then from B to E, we have G2. So here we will write this as G2. From E to C, we have G3. So here we will write it as G3. Now see here, from VS to CS, we have only unity gain. So we can connect this VS to CS and we will mark this as 1. Now we will take care of the other signals. First of all, let's see this E. At E we have two incoming signals. One is from D, second one is from G. From D we have already taken care. From G we have a signal to E which is going in this direction. Here the sign is minus and the gain is 1. So G to E we can plot it like this and we can mark this as minus 1 because the gain of this is minus 1. Now G to F. G to F we have gain H2. So here we will mark this as H2. Then F to D, again we have this as negative sign with the gain 1. So this is minus 1. Then F to B, we have the gain H1 and the sign is negative. So it will be minus H1. So it is like this. We can write this as minus H1. So F to B, we have minus H1. Now this H3 is there. C of S to G, we have the gain H3. So we can mark like this. This is H3. The gain is H3. Now we are left with this block, that is of H4. From CS to A, it is going through gain H4 block with the sign minus. So we can plot it like this. Here, and this symbol is minus H4. So this is the conversion of, or the transformation of block diagram into the signal flow graph. Now this is the signal flow graph. Now we have the SFG where we have all these variables represented as node, that is R of S, A, B, D, E, C, F, G, and V. And all the gains are marked on this SFG. Now we can apply the Bessel's gain formula over here for getting the overall transfer function. Now see here, this summing point is represented over here. A, basically the output of summing point, that is the output variable's value. What is the value of node A? The value of node A is R of S minus H4 C of S. Here's R of S minus H4 C of S. So this is perfectly all right. The value of B is A minus H1F. This is A minus H1F. And so, if you compare these two, we'll find that exactly we have transformed all the values of the nodes on this SFG. Now we will apply the Mason's gain formula for getting the transfer function of this system. Now remove this block diagram because the work of this block diagram is over. Now we have already converted this block diagram into the signal flow graph. So we don't need this block diagram now. Now for the block diagram, we will have to find that how many forward parts do we have in this signal flow graph. We know that the Mason's gain formula says that transfer function T is given as summation of k pk del k over del. And for getting the value where P is the product of forward path, this represents the gain product of gain for forward path. That means first of all we need to find that how many forward paths we have. That means k represents the number of forward paths. So in this, first of all, we'll find that how many forward paths do we have. And of course, the task was given to find, this was the task, that is C of S over R of S. This is number one. And number two, it is asked that C of S over V of S. That means we have to apply the superposition theorem. So in this case, we are going to use one input at a time. So let us consider the first part. Here, so for this first part, that is C of S over R of S, we'll have to use V of S equals to 0. So if we consider V of S equals to 0, this is as good as no connection. Right? So for time being, just remove this. Now we have this signal flow graph with us. For this, we will have to find that how many forward paths we have. See here, the forward paths. The signal is moving from input node R to A. It cannot go like this because arrow sign is in the opposite direction. Then A to B, it cannot move like this because arrow sign is in the opposite direction. Similarly, B to D, here also it cannot move. D to E, here also it cannot move. Then E to C. So the forward path, the total number of forward path that we have in this SFG is only 1. So the value of K is 1. So here K is equals to 1. So that means we are going to have PK as P1. And what is P1? It's a product of all the gains encountered while traveling from input node to the output node. That means while traveling in the forward path. So P1 is 1 multiplied by 1 multiplied by G1 multiplied by G2 multiplied by G3. So this is simply G1, G2, G3. So here we have P1. Now we need to find the del. For del K, we need to have the del. And we know that for del, for finding out the del, we must have the values for individual loops, values for two non-touching loops, combination two non-touching loops, all combinations of three non-touching loops. So we will have to find that how many individual loops are available in this signal flow graph. Now let us start with this at E. E to C, C to G, G to E. This is one loop. So let us mark this as first individual loop L11. So that is, and the gain is minus G3, H3. And the path that we are following, what is the path? E, C, G, E. It is E, C, G, E. So this is one loop. This is the first loop. So its gain is minus G3, H3. Now let's say the second one, that is L2, 1. We'll start with D. G2, G3. H3, H2, minus 1. This is another loop. So the gain is minus G2, G3, H3, H2. And the path that we are following is DEC, DEC, GFD. DEC, GFD. So this is L2 one. Now L3-1, let us start with B. B to D, D to E, E to C, C to G, G to F, F to B back. So this is another loop, individual loop. So the gain is, it starts with the minus sign, that is minus H1. So let us say this is minus, we are going from here. So it is G1, G2, G3, H3, H2, H1. So this is L3-1. And the path that we have followed, path is, we are starting with B. So B, D, E, C, G, F, then B. This is the path that we have followed. Now L4-1. Let's start with A. A to B, B to D, D to E, E to C, and C to A. So this is making another loop. So its gain is, let us select minus 1 multiplied by G1, so this is G1, G2, G3, and then H4. So G1, G2, G3, H4, this is one loop. And the path that we are following is A, B, D, E, C, and A. So these are the paths.
So these are the initial two that we have with us, that is L11, L21, L31, L41. Now apart from this, we don't have any other loop. This is one loop, this is second loop, this is third loop, and the overall is the fourth loop. Now we'll have to find that how many of this makes the combination of two non-touching loops. And we know that in every point we have common, that is E to C. So there is no question of two non-touching or three non-touching or any other non-touching combinations. So in this case, we are going to have only individual loops. We do not have any non-touching, two non-touching loops or combination of three non-touching loops or four non-touching loops. So we know that del equals to 1 minus it's all individual loops, that is sum of the gain of all individual loops. So it is 1 minus L11 plus L21 plus L31 plus L41, since we have up to L41, then plus next and the remaining part, since we don't have any combinations of two non-touching or three non-touching, so this becomes 0. So we have these are 1 minus L11, L21, L31, L41, that's sum of those values. So here we write the transfer function. So in this case, the transfer function, that is C of S over R of S, this is given as P1 del 1. So P1 is G1, G2, G3, and del 1, it is 1 minus, since we do not have, since for this particular part, all the loops are touching this particular part, so we will have to make this as 0. So it is 0 plus 0 plus 0 plus 0. This divided by del, that is 1 minus, we know that L11 is minus G3 H3, then minus G2 G3 H3 H2, minus G1 G2 G3 H3 H2 H1, and minus G1 G2 G3 H4. So this is the total del. Now we'll write in the proper way. So we have the transfer function, that is C of S over R of S. This is equals to, since this term is 0, so G1, G2, G3 multiplied by 1. So that becomes G1, G2, G3. This divided by, write all this term. So since this all internal values are having the sign negative, and outside also there is negative, so it will be positive. So it becomes 1 plus G3 H3 plus G2 G3 H2 H3 plus G1 G2 G3 H1 H2 H3 plus G1 G2 G3 H4. So this is the transfer function of the first part that is asked in the question, that is to determine the transfer, overall transfer function for the gain for C of S over R of S. So this is the final result for this transfer gain. Now we need to find the second part, that is C of S over V of S. I think now this is clear that how we have applied the Messel's gain formula. Here we have written this L11, L21, L31, L41 separately. If you do more practice, then you will be able to write all this loops gain and non-touching loops gains directly into this formula. There is no need to list out all the gains over here. If you have the practice, you can definitely write the expressions directly into this expression, that will save the time. But if you have the confidence and if you have the more practices for this for solving of SLG, otherwise you must list this so that the error can be found out with this method. Because if you made any mistake over here, it's very difficult to get the solution, or it's very difficult to debug the solution, debug the error. So if you want, you can move with this. If you have the practice, then definitely you can directly write this expressions. So now, for the second part, that is C of S over V of S. Now we'll write this directly. This is for the first part. Now the second one is C of S over V of S. Now find out how many forward paths we have. Now in this case, since we are considering V of S, so there is no question of using R of S. So this is removed. This is connected now. Now we do not have anything like R of S in the circuit. So this is this signal flow graph called this. So how many forward paths do we have? There is only one forward path, that is from V of S to C of S, and the gain is 1. So the P1 is again here. We can mark this as P1 as 1. And since C of S is common node for all these loops, that is why there is no question of any non-touching. So this is 1 multiplied by, we can write here as 1 minus 0 plus 0 plus 0 plus 0 divided by the complete digit. Right? Because there is not going to change. So the overall result is C of S over V of S, that is equals to 1 divided by this complete term, that is 1 plus G3 H3 plus G2 G3 H2 H3 plus G1 G2 G3 H1 H2 H3 plus G1 G2 G3 H1. So this is the result of C of S versus V of S. Always remember, since we are taking care of the signal flow graph, the loops are not going to change even if you will change the input. Right? So here, there remains the same. Forward path that we need to find, because that is going to change. Because the forward path always moves from one input side to the output side. Since we have changed the input, so definitely the forward path will change. But there remains the same. That's why here we have this del common. Because in this SFG, since we have removed this, it is not changing any loop. So there is no question of that. Now this is about the type 2. Now we'll see about the type 3. We have finished with the type first and type second. In type first, we are saying that if we have the algebraic equations, how to construct the SFG with those algebraic equations and how to apply the Bessel's game formula on that. In second part, we are saying that if we have the block diagram of any system, how to construct the SFG through block diagram and how to apply the Mason's game formula. In type third, we will construct the block diagram. Construction of block diagram from the given signal flow graph. Now this is just the reverse, and of course hence to determine the transfer function. If in exam it is asked, construct block diagram from the given signal flow graph and hence determine the transfer function. That means in that case, though it is not mentioned, but you will have to follow the block reduction technique method for getting the transfer function. Otherwise, if the question is given, construct block diagram from the given signal flow graph, that is number one task. And number two task, also find the overall transfer function of the given system. In that case, it is up to you that whether you are going to use the Bessel's game formula or block reduction technique method. But in the first type that we have discussed, that first construct this block diagram in the signal flow graph and hence determine the transfer function or the overall transfer function or the overall gain of the system, then definitely you will have to use the block diagram reduction technique method. And if it is behind number one task, that is to construct the block diagram from the given signal flow graph, then number two, to determine overall transfer function, then it's up to you whether you will have to use the Bessel's game formula or block diagram reduction technique method. Unless it is mentioned, I suggest you to go for Bessel's game formula, because that makes your life easier and that will take very small period of time for solving. So let us take an example. SFG of a certain control system is shown B. Part A
straw block diagram for the system. B, determine C of S over R of S. So here we will see how to convert the SFG into the block diagram. And the signal flow graph that we have with us is mark this as 1, 1. This gain is G1. This gain is G2. This gain is G3. This gain is G4. Here we have the gain G5. This gain is minus H2 of S. This is minus H1 of S, and from here up to this is of course C of S. This gain is minus 1. Right. So this is the signal flow graph that we have with us. Now we have to convert this into the block diagram, and then we'll use the method either block diagram production technique or Mason's gain formula for finding out the transfer function. So the main thing that we are trying to learn here is how to convert the signal flow graph into the block diagram. Now there are certain rules for this. Always remember, if at any node, if we have more than two or more incoming signals, then that will always represent the summing point. Now we'll see the certain rules for this conversion. Number one, if we have two or more incoming signals at a node. If you have two or more incoming signals at a node, then it represents summing point. That means like this. Basically, we'll have it like this. This is the node. Here we have two incoming signals, so it represents the summing point. So this is the first part. Number two, if we have one incoming signals and more than one outgoing signals, if we have one incoming and two outgoing, or two or more outgoing signals, then it represents takeoff point. It is like this. Let us say here there is a node. So this represents the takeoff point. Now the third case is if you have two or more incoming signals and two or more outgoing signals at a node, then it represents summing point with takeoff. For example, this is the node. Here we have one incoming signal. Here there is another incoming signal. This is one outgoing signal. This is another outgoing signal. So this will be converted as, we can have a summing point like this, and then the output, and here we can use the takeoff point. So if we have two or more incoming signals and two or more outgoing signals at a node, then it presents the summing point with takeoff point. Now we try to apply all these three methods
for this particular SFG to convert into the block diagram. So number one is two or more incoming signals at a node, that is the serving point. Now here at this particular node we have two incoming signals and one outgoing signals, and definitely this is coming under the category of the first part, that is two or more incoming signals at a node. So it represents the summing point. So here we are going to have the summing point like this. So it is something like this. Now second node. Here we have two incoming signals and one outgoing signals. So again this is representing a summing point. So we are going to have the summing point like this over here. Then at this particular node, just see, one incoming signals, second incoming signals, this is outgoing, this is outgoing. So at this particular point, we are getting two incoming signals and two outgoing signals. So it falls under the category of number 3, that is two or more incoming signals and two or more outgoing signals at a node. So it will be represented as summing point with takeoff point. So here, this point will be represented as a summing point. So one input we are getting over here, second input will be like this, then output will be over here, that is this, and then there is a takeoff point. So these two will be represented like this, takeoff points. Is this clear? So at this particular node, we have two incoming signals and two outgoing signals. So this falls under the third category, that is two or more incoming signals and two or more outgoing signals at node. So it represents the summing point with takeoff point. So this is the way how to plot or how to convert. So we are marking this as summing point and takeoff point. Now see here, at this particular node, this is incoming signals and we have two outgoing signals, and definitely this is representing a takeoff point because it comes under the category of number 2, that is one incoming and two or more outgoing signals. So here we have two, it can be or more. So here we have one incoming signal and two outgoing signal. So it is like this. So this is represented as takeoff. At this particular node, we have two incoming signals and one outgoing signal. Then this represents the summing point. It is like this. This is one incoming signal, this is another incoming signal, and here we have the outgoing signal. And finally, here we have one incoming signals and two outgoing signals. So this is represented as takeoff points. It is like this. So this represents the takeoff points. Now we will combine all these symbols: summing point 1, summing point 2, summing point 3 with takeoff point. This takeoff point, summing point 4, and this takeoff points. If we add, if we connect all these symbols along with its gain block, then this will be automatically converted into the block diagram. We'll convert this into the block diagram. Gain of G1 that will go as one of the input to the
summing point over here with positive signs, so here it will be positive. Then here we have this as negative H2S, so we will mark this as negative. Initially we will just transfer or we will just post the sign on the summing point signals. And then after that we have G2 as the block. So here we will plot another block, that is G2, and here we have the takeoff point. At this moment we also have a takeoff point, so that takeoff point will be taken like this. It will go from here, and here we have the gain G5. So here we will block, we will draw another block with the gain G5. Leave it at this moment. Now at this particular point we have the takeoff point, that is after G2. So here we can have the takeoff point like this. Here it is going to the G3 block. So here we have another block, that is G3. This is represented as summing point. So we will have another summing point over here. This sign is positive because this is plus G3. So this is positive. And the second incoming signal is coming from this G5, and that is also positive. So we will plot this over here with the sign plus. So this we are taking care. And this C of S is takeoff point. So here we can say that this is C of S, and we will bring this takeoff point like this. Now between C of S and D, that means this, we have H2 of S. So we mark this as X2 of S. Already we have posted the negative sign, so we have taken care of this minus S2 of S. Then here, between, let us say this is E, between E and B, we have minus H1 of S. Minus we have already posted over here, so we need to plot the H1 of S. And E is after G2, so here we have H1 of S, it is like this. This is the second block. Now, third one is coming from C of S to A with the gain 1 with the negative sign. Negative sign we already posted, so we have to plot again 1. So it is like this. This gain is 1. So that is all about the conversion of signal flow graph into the block diagram. I think now it is very clear how to convert the signal flow graph into the block diagram. We will revise this in a short. First of all, we will have to find what is the value of this nodes and what is the status of at that particular node. That means how many incoming signals we have, how many outgoing signals we have. Accordingly, we can mark this at the node just for our sake of understanding that what we are going to plot in this case. Then just post this over here, and intermediate gains has to be posted in between those summing points or takeoff point. Then it will give you the resultant block diagram for the SVG. So here we have done the same thing. We have first marked the conversion point, that is summing point or takeoff points on this SVG. Then we have posted it over here without gain, and then we have inserted all the gains inside the block, and then we are having the final block diagram for this signal flow graph. Now the second part, that is to find the transfer gain. Now I am leaving it to you that whether you are trying to follow the block diagram reduction technique or signal flow graph. I suggest for this particular block diagram, you can use block diagram reduction technique for the first time and get the overall transfer function. Then in the second part, instead of using this block diagram, you already have a signal flow graph. You can apply the Message Gain formula and obtain a transfer function, and then compare both whether we are getting the same result or not. If you are getting the same result, perfectly post it. If it is not, then you have to debug that whether there is a problem in the conversion of SFG into the block diagram or applying the formula or applying the reduction method into the system. And I will give you the result
that what is going to be the result for this? The resultant transfer function, that is the result, its transfer function is C of S over R of S is equals to G1, G2, G3, G4 plus G1, G3, G4. This divided by 1 plus G1, G2, G3, G4 plus G1, G5, G4 plus G1, G2, H1 of S minus G, sorry, this is plus G2, G3, G4, H2 of S plus G5, G4, H2 of S. So this is going to be the overall transfer function for this systems. Now it's up to you whether you are applying the block diagram regression technique or Mersenne-Gen formula. I'll suggest that you can use both the methods for getting this overall transfer function and then compare whether you are getting the same result or not. So today we'll stop over here. In the next lecture we will see the type 4th category of the SFG, where we can have the electrical circuits or the electronic circuits, and we'll see how to convert those electrical circuits into the signal program, and then we'll see how to apply the Mersenne-Gen formula on this signal program. Thank you.